Hey friends, this is Miss Jessica. I'm so happy you're here with us today. We are going to start today by declaring God's word because God's word is powerful. So join me in reading today's verse out loud at home. Today's verse comes from Peter chapter 5 verse 10. Yes, you will suffer for a short time, but after that God will make everything right. He will make you strong. He will support you and keep you from falling. He is a God who gives all grace. He called you to share in his glory in Christ. That glory will continue forever. Good job, boys and girls. In today's Bible story, we will hear how the people of Jerusalem turned away from their sins and how God supported them, restored them, forgave them, and showed them grace. But before we get into our Bible story, I just want to thank everyone who submitted a picture for our praise video. It was so nice to see all of your faces. We miss you so much. Now let's get up on our feet and praise together.
Oh, and girls. This is Mrs. Lily. I'm excited to share with you all this week's Bible lesson. Our big picture question is, who is in control of everything? Please listen to the story to help answer that question.
God's people repented. Nehemiah chapter 8 through 13. The walls around Jerusalem were finished at last. With God's help, the people finished rebuilding the walls and the city gates in just 52 days. All the people in Jerusalem gathered together early in the morning at one of the city gates. Men, women, and children, anyone who could understand, came to listen to the reading of God's word. As the sun was just coming up, Ezra, the priest, brought out the book of the law of Moses that God had given to his people. God's words were written on a scroll. Ezra stood on a wooden platform and began to read. Ezra read the law for hours, and all the people stood up. They had respect for God's word. Ezra praised God, and the people lifted their hands. Amen, amen, they said. The people in the crowd bowed down with their faces to the ground, and they worshiped God. Some of the leaders there, the Levites, explained the law of the people and help them understand the words Ezra read. As people heard the words of the law, they began to cry.
They realized they had sinned. Ezra, the Levites, and Nehemiah, the governor, said, "This day is holy to the Lord your God. Do not be sad or cry." Even though the people's sin made them sad, this was a happy day. Then Ezra said to them, "Go home and prepare a feast. Eat rich food and drink sweet drinks. Share what you have prepared with those who have nothing prepared." And again Ezra said, "Today is holy to the Lord our God. This is not a day to be sad, because the joy of the Lord is our strength." The people obeyed Ezra. They prepared a feast. They were glad because they understood the words of the law that were explained to them. Nehemiah led God's people to repent and confess their sin. They agreed to worship only God and promised to obey him.
Do you remember this week's big picture question? Please repeat it after me. Who is in control of everything? God is in control of everything, here in earth and in heaven. That's right, boys and girls. God knows when things will start and finish. And he cares about every part of our lives and works out all things for his glory and our good. Let's pray. Father God, we praise you for who you are. You're loving, you are giving, and you're powerful. We confess that sometimes we turn away from you. Thank you for always forgiving us and welcoming us back when we repent. Help us to follow you every day of our lives, and help us lead others to find their joy and rest in you. We love you and we praise you. In Jesus' precious name we pray. Amen. Boys and girls, remember this week, God's promise is to restore and support us. Thank you for watching, and we'll see you next week.